here with Stephen Brooks after Chesapeake wins the MLL championship. Stephen, first off, what's going through your mind right now? What are the emotions?
I don't know. It's so hard to think about it. It's just a happy day. From April to today, we've been talking about this as a family. We stuck together. We like to call ourselves the Penguins because we keep close, tight. And we always, wherever families go, wherever Penguins go, you migrate with each other, and that's what we did. No matter what happened, with the ups and downs of the season, we always stuck together. We bent, but we never broke.
Who came up with that nickname?
I don't know. I think it was Spallina, actually. He goes, guys, get in here in the huddle like Penguins. Get in there. And we started going, rah, rah. And then it just spread. And then, who knows? I mean, it was like a wildfire. Everybody started doing it.
It's interesting because you have so many new guys on this team, kind of the way the team was built. Everybody came together. What can you say about the way this roster was built and how you came together throughout the season?
I think the big thing is having veterans on the team that's been here before, that's able to keep a cool kettle and make sure everybody stay calm and don't freak out, you know? I mean, coming from young guys to older guys were able to help out the young guys, and we all stuck together. I mean, that's the biggest thing that made us so good this year, is that we always stuck together no matter what. And we always say we're family. We're all family, and we did this together. No matter what, from the 19 guys that dressed to even the other guys that weren't dressed, and they always came in every week and busted their butts and pushed us to get here today.
Knowing how many veterans you had, was it at all on your mind that you'd have to play two games in 24 hours to win it all? I mean, was that
it was huge. You know, we got through yesterday just to get to today, and we all knew that we had to do the same thing we did yesterday to today. And like right after the game yesterday, we all got on bikes, we all got in pools, and we all did team ice baths. So one will go switch, and just to get ready for today, and it was great.
What do you think changed specifically from the last time you played the Outlaws at the end of the regular season?
I mean, it's a big thing of just adjusting to the things that we didn't do successfully last time we played them, and we had to come up with a different game plan, and we did. You know, the best thing about the season is that you're able to correct the mistakes that you have in the season, and then when you come to playoffs, you're able to fix it. And the big thing is to be able to fix it. Cottle, Resch, and Reese put their heads together and came up with a magnificent plan to how to play these two teams, and you know, we're great. We stuck to our plan, and we're victorious.
Seemed like specifically on offense you spread out a little bit more, share the ball a little bit more.
Yeah, we just had to talk to not make sure the ball doesn't stay stagnant. We got to move. Once we move the ball around, get the defense going, we're able to pick our poison and go with it.
You have so many weapons offensively. What can you say about just that group?
I just think the best thing is nobody's selfish on that team. Everybody wants to give either a goal for somebody else or to get a ball, pick up a ground ball, and we all just wanted to stick together. And the biggest thing is, push statistics aside, we want to get a win. That's the big thing for us.
Ben Rubier's named MVP. What stood out about his performance?
Oh my God, he's a quiet storm. I couldn't believe he put in six yesterday. How many put in today?
I think four more.
He's like a quiet storm, and he was unbelievable. He is the MVP. Obviously, he's the MVP. He was a big turnaround for us this year.
How about the performance of Alex Smith at the X?
He's huge. You know, he came. We were lucky. Adam Rand did a terrific job for us this year. And once Alex Smith got healthy, him and Rand were battling. And then Smith got healthy, and you know, being able to win faceoffs is huge for us, and that's maintain possessions.
Defensively, you're physical, tough, playing in front of Kip. Seemed like nobody wanted to have the ball, frankly, against that defense.
It goes down to veterans. Veterans are able to do everything for us. They communicate. We'll be running down the field, and you hear Spallina's voice yelling at us, telling us where to go, and that's huge. Communication's a big thing for us when we get back there. And Kip did a fantastic job in between the pipes today. I think he probably had about 16 saves. Unbelievable. And then, team effort, that's all I got to say.
On the other side, you see Mundorf go down. Obviously, you never want to see a competitor like that go down, but did that boost your psyche at all? How did you kind of approach it?
No, you know, honestly, I felt bad. You know, he worked so hard to get the MVP and to get here today. A little fluke incident rolls his ankle. I just felt terrible for him because, you know, you want to be able to give him the best shot, and you want to play the best, the Outlaws and with their best players. And it was just unfortunate for him, and I feel really bad.
Congratulations on a great season.
Thank you very much.